Hello everyone, welcome back to the Darkest Dungeon, wherein it's been a couple of days. Let's see what we did last episode. Let's refresh my memory. People leveled up. We did get a lot of level 5s now. We could probably think about doing one of these. We have Miri up at level 6 because of that event. We beat the Siren, of course we did. So, we are making some progress on the bosses, but there are several. There are many more. And the one that I was expecting to get the best results out of, we have had a great trouble doing. And the one that I was expecting to be a massive amount of difficulty turned out to be quite easy. We still have the 12-pounder, which is going to be harder than the previous one, and the previous one was the one that killed the original Dutch. The Swine King should be doable, but we're running out of people who can actually do it. And that's the problem. We're also running out of people who can go anywhere at all. So we need... Basically, we don't have a healer at the moment, and that's going to be a bit of an issue. In fact, we don't have a healer down there at all, but we can send Zeki out on a level 3 mission if we wanted to. In fact, maybe we should. Let's spec this out. We're going to have Zeki here. We can have sort of Martinus doing a dancing around thing. Megistos and DT. Now, I've been looking at some strategies for beating the Prophet here. Obviously, what you need is to be able to hit the Prophet, so we're not going to be taking this party as it is to beat the Prophet, but one thing you can do is take a Man-at-Arms with the guard thing, the defender, and use that to tank the damage from the falling rubble. Instead of trying to get your people into position, you just use an ability that guards somebody already in that position and puts the damage on the Man-at-Arms instead, which is actually a pretty good idea. Plus, if you then combine that with, say, Pete's ability to reduce their damage, the weakening curse, you know, three of these, and they're basically doing no damage. So between them, you can tank a lot of the damage that it would be doing from something that's usually a high damage attack in the first place. However, that does, of course, make it kind of difficult to hit the back position, because you'd have to have something here that would allow... This unit can only hit the back if it does that. Now, they could be wailing away at the front things, and you do get a bonus out of the Prophet if you break the pews. If we broke the pews and moved the Prophet forward, we would then be in a position where we couldn't hit the back if we took something like a Hellion to do the Iron Swan, because that can only hit the back. So we have a choice. Either we take enough damage to remove the pews and a lot of debuffs, i.e. Pete and a Megistos or similar, or we take like just shitload of people who can hit the back, like New Dutch with the sniper shot and a Hellion, but we haven't got any Hellions, so we can't do that. So it looks like what we're going to be basically doing is trying to debuff it. And that means we don't have to take a Crusader, because a Crusader can basically only hit the front things and not that hard. Shall we try this with this party? Now, the reason I'm thinking of this is that Zeki here has Tetanus, which is okay for a Vestal, because the Vestal is going to be doing healing predominantly. If we take Erasmus, Erasmus has the snuff box, so any diseases that we get on the way, we can probably cure, at least we can try to. If there's more than one other person besides Erasmus, Martinus with the disease, then obviously Marty can only actually get rid of their own and then one other person. But as I keep accidentally saying, we do have Erasmus ready. Not ready, so what we might do is go back to and then send Rasmus in for... We'll not pray or flagellate, that's fine. We'll send Erasmus in to get some drinks in him, so that next time Erasmus is available if Marty fails. But we're slowly running out of people to send places. So at some point, basically, we're going to have to do a level 5 mission, because we only have level 5 people who are not completely stressed out or dead. We do have a space. Now, the reason I haven't taken anyone yet is that they're going to just sort of be stuck at the bottom. Without any... Like, there's literally no opportunity to upgrade a Hellion at level 1, and certainly not anyone at level 0, up to a level where we actually want them to be useful. But if we can get them to level 3 or 4, really I just want to get more busts and start bringing in more experienced recruits. But if people start dying more often, we could then be in a position where the churn is enough to let us do the low-level missions again, start leveling people up, start getting some money, and start sending Sagiris out to get some, you know, a decent boost in cash. but until then, I think we're just going to try a second boss. The Swine King is doable. Excuse me. We do have a certain amount of DPS. Maybe we don't want to take Megistos, because I do like Retribution, though. It's really good. And you can mark yourself, and I'm pretty sure the Swine King basically works in terms of marking, because the little piggy thing that tells it what to do is marking stuff. So maybe we... like, we can get through the dungeon with these things, but maybe we want to turn Defender on for the next sort of... for the actual boss. The other thing is, we're not all leveled up fully. Although, maybe we try and level that up. Let's see how much that costs. Be in the guild. Megistos. 375. Oh, we can upgrade him even more. I don't want to spend that much money because we need to provision. Maybe we try? Let's try. The worst that happens is on the next episode, we send out level 5s and see who survives, right? So, let's just do this. I'm feeling a bit angsty about not having had the opportunity to beat or fight these bosses for quite some time. We're going to make sure we're well provisioned. As much as possible, at least. Maybe we sell some of this food back and buy one of these instead. Probably some anti-venom. It's only a level 3 mission, but at the same time. A couple of these. Don't really need a key again. We don't worry about keys so much because bringing back stuff is secondary to actually beating the boss in the first place. And if we get lucky, hopefully we'll get as good a layout of dungeon as we had in the last mission, where it was just straight from the entrance, a few rooms, there's the boss. Is this good enough? No, because we haven't done trinkets. Now we're kind of going to... is there any point bringing trinkets back? Maybe. What have we got here? Move resist speed. I think we want dodge. Can we stun the big boss? Maybe not. I mean, this is usually a good idea, isn't it? The quick draw charm, and then maybe something that improves our crit. Position 4 is not you. Position 1 is not you. Well, it could be, but your shadow fade out of position 1. More damage, more stress damage. Possibly that? We are on 0 stress. What are we fearing here? That's okay. That's kind of okay. Not that good. So we don't have anything that actually is a problem in the warrens. So I think we can happily take an extra 10% stress damage to try and do much more damage with the very damaging skills that we have. Plus, I think there's a lot of beasts in there, right? Warrens? Sounds right. Zeke has already got the same things as last time. Oh, excuse me. More dodge is probably pretty good, because the Swine King is going to do a lot of attacks on everybody. And if we can have an attack on Megistos that is dodged, and it was aimed at somebody else, and has a riposte, that's going to be really good. More max HP is not a terrible idea. Probably put more damage on DT over here. But for now, I think we just take both man-at-arms trinkets. DT, are you in the right position? Yes. Just double check that. More damage to melee. More speed. More speed could be good, actually. I've been finding that I've been neglecting speed as a stat, and I'm thinking, you know, it's not that good. You know, we can get better stuff out of speed. And I saw this and I went, this is shit. You know, it's just speed. But at the same time, the number of times that I've gone, can I have a go, please? Because all the enemies have been having a go first. More scout chance could be okay. But I think we're going to take the position one bonus. Yeah. A bit less speed, I guess. That counters that. It just allows us to actually get a hit in when everything's wailing away on us. Sometimes we've had terrible rounds just because we've gone last. And I want to try and avoid that. So I think I'm happy with this. Yeah. I mean, hopefully we don't proc too many things that cause the run to go horribly wrong on the way, but in for a penny.
My first attempts at summoning were crude, and the results disappointing. I soon found, however, that the type and condition of the host's meat was a critical factor. The best results came from pigs, whose flesh is most like that of man.
That's true.
A nameless abomination.
In terms of biologically, I believe they use...
It must be destroyed.
They either use pigs' hearts in people, or they use people's hearts in pigs, or something like that. Cool, money. Good start. No combat. No combat. No trap, no combat. No trap, no combat. No trap, no combat.
Blood.
Good. So it's not as far as it could be. Sometimes we get horribly windy passages. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's got to be here, basically. 4 rooms is probably the best we could have hoped for, but there's still plenty of opportunity for shit to go down. And if we do really well, which when we're this close to the boss, I'm hoping we do. I'm scared of every single tile being a sudden attack. If we do well when we're this close to the boss, we can always go back, look at the curios, try and pick something up, try and do some combat to get some, you know, decent value out of it. Bring something home besides victory against the Swine King.
Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
Probably combat here, yeah. Well, they are surprised, so what we can do is get Erasmus to try and hit something. How far can you go? This far back. Could kill that, actually. Can't kill that, so I think we try and kill this. What? Raz. Razmataz. You fucking joker. What are you saying to me here? Are you okay in this position? You can do some stuff. In fact, you could do retribution, which is basically what you're here for. I wish you could hit that. What's our damages here? 11, 10. Or we could mark, but no one else really benefits from a mark. We've got stunned, but we don't have surprise. Surprise doesn't count as stunned. We can stun this, maybe? 45%. It's worth a try. And now this is in range of EG Erasmus, although... We can stun this as well. This is the knock... This is the, No, this is retribution here. Riposte. But I'm thinking maybe... Do we do any damage? We do some damage. Like, with 2 stunned ones, it's a small chance, or at least a reasonable chance, of Megistos. Oh, that moves you forward, of course it does. Well, that was actually really silly. Not that silly. Yeah, we could do that one. So that's actually really good. We should start in this position. Unfortunately, there's no way of changing the default party order, but there you go. Maybe we try and judgment this one? It's got some dodge. But it didn't dodge. So I'm happy with that. Because we managed to get rid of one, just as a direct result of Erasmus being great on the first round. Of course, speed's going to be down a lot on subsequent rounds. And that's okay, but it does mean that Erasmus is right at the front. It's Martinus. Dude, it's Martinus. Not Erasmus. Hemophilia is... less bleed resist. That's fine, because don't forget, Erasmus... Martinus will be curing most of his own shit anyway. Right, well, that didn't help. Just start smacking things. We're so slow. There was always a chance that both stuns would come off before we got a go. I mean, I guess that's okay. Run away! Resisted the stun, which is expected with the 40% extra that we've got here. Now is the time to start healing because I don't want to leave it and go, no, one more round, it's fine. And then, you know, dead. Good dodge. Excellent. More like this. So now we set up retribution on us. We do some damage to something. Probably this. Yeah, that's really good. Now we got a riposte. And a mark. So maybe this will attack us. Yeah. It could just be that we have to. It dodged. Okay. That's fine. The stress is okay at the moment. Right, so we're going to have this for 3 rounds, I think. That's less prop. It does have a lot of prop. I'm going to do this because it will literally benefit everybody, provided that, yeah, the less prop does happen. But it will also benefit us for being able to do versus marked. Do you do damage versus marked? I think not. No. So we'll just crush. The less prop means that we do that much more damage. I'm thinking maybe we shadow fade now. We don't need to. We can throw a dagger. Oh, damage versus marked. Yeah, definitely. Give them no quarter. So that was an accidental synergy I set up there. I didn't really consider that Martinus... yes. would be able to actually successfully, you know, get a benefit out of the mark. I only did the mark because of the debuff that reduced the protection, but everything sort of came up roses. Dodge and speed, but no protection. So I think we just start hitting it. Everyone has an attack that can hit it. Unfortunately, we're vomiting with a crit. This is a debuff, but not a majorly awful one. Marty is actually being really good right now. I don't mean to suggest that that's a surprise. That shouldn't be the case. So if I do this... Yeah, that's really annoying. I want to save the default party order. Can I right-click? No. That's annoying, because if I thought of that... I hadn't realized that this was a better position, because if Megistos is still in the second position, we can do all of these, including Crush. But DT can do everything that I find valuable from the third position. Like, it's only uppercut we can't do. But it also means that Megistos can move back into position immediately after Marty's done the thingy, whereas he couldn't otherwise. Anyway, we'll leave that for now. We don't have a key. But if we find a key, or we just have time and we feel up to it. Oh, you're bleeding. Get over it. Oh, now you're bleeding again. Not bleeding again, it's fine.
Traps lie in wait, unsprung and thirsting for blood.
If we find a key, or if we have some time, we'll come back to that chest, but I don't want the potential debuff that you get out of the chest to cause us to have trouble against the boss, basically. Right, you. Probably this. There's a higher chance to kill something, and I think that's what we should do. Didn't. So you can finish this. Do you get anything for doing that? Yes. So you buff yourself, but you can't hit that. Argh! Oh, it doesn't buff yourself. It just literally is that. In that case, kill something. I think that's the better idea. Make sure something is... Ooh. This game makes my throat... I can talk about Isaac. I've just done an Isaac run. And it was... I've been talking for like 40 minutes, right? No problem. This game, I've been doing it for 18 minutes. Like, I can do several Isaac runs in a row. It's not like it's because I've done an Isaac run that I now can't talk at all. Bleed is fine. I think we want to save these things for the boss or an emergency. That would have been a good time to have already had... Oh, your marks, sir. Okay, that's okay. To have already had... Human, yes. Riposte active. Guess we do that. It's a really bad roll, actually. An upsettingly poor roll. We did resist the stun, which I'm happy with. And now that they're spreading around the damage, of course, it'll take us longer to die, but it'll also take us longer to recover from it. When we get to the boss. Although we do have a feast coming up. Throne dagger. Can be really good. Especially if we crit. Unfortunately, you're going first, which is a bit of a shame. How much damage are you going to do to this corpse? You could get rid of the corpse. But that's a really low amount of damage there, whereas this is way more. Yeah, and a crit as well. Probably makes that worth doing. I'd like to remove this corpse, to be honest. Let's set up retribution again and see if we can do at least some damage to this Joker. And then if we ever get attacks, at least we can maybe try and take something out. Some damage again, but 4 damage for 3 rounds, I think we'll be okay.
Oh. Injury.
Stress marked. Dunno. I think we just try and get rid of one. I mean, we were guaranteed to get rid of that one, which is why I chose it, but nothing's moving forwards because we don't have any damage over time. It's becoming a problem. Although we could try and get Marty here to hit the thing at the back. We have got this on a couple of times, so I was just wondering as to whether to try and use this one, which would obviously stun it, or the other one, which might do more damage, but also I wasn't sure whether it was actually worth doing that bit extra. Oh, we're now flashing daggers to try and get rid of that corpse, which did work. And that unit as well. Completely unintentional, but again, the creeps coming out of Martinez here are just ludicrous. You don't have any prop. Now, it will increase Marty's damage with the thrown dagger, but I kind of think we don't need to. Yeah, we really don't need to. Drums of Doom is... Well, it hit the one person who it mattered to hit. Unfortunately, it hit them, but at the same time, whatever. It's a trap. That's fine. We'll go back to default order, and we'll go to the new default order. They won't scout and let me do that at the same time. That's fine. So the boss is where we expected. There's a secret room as well, but we didn't bring a key, which is kind of a bit bad. That was very... less than erudite way of saying that, but what I mean is we couldn't afford to bring a key. And the one time we actually genuinely find a secret room, we can't use it, which is upsetting to some extent. Right, so we're going to try and get rid of our own disease and this tetanus here. So we'll do that on you. Excellent. More scouting chance is not that useful now, because we know we're in the right place for the boss. So we could always just beat the boss and leave. Which I think, once again, we have... Every single run that we've done in the ruins so far has just been fraught with... just bad, bad luck. You know, it's not like... In some cases, we took a bad party. But in other cases... I can see him crit. Probably that. In other cases... The boss has just been so far away, we've had to get through so many rooms. In this one, we've had to get through 4 rooms, which I think has been 3 or 4 combats so far. Maybe only 2 combats. More dodge, more speed. The dodge might help. In fact, that basically adds to our existing idea, where we're trying to set up a riposte and then dodge. War companions plus 10 damage. So that's 4, and that's 3. What else do we have? We should check. Less stress damage and less stress. More prop and reduced stress. We've done these. I think we do both of these. Now, it's all companions, not yourself, remember. But we then buff ourselves. Oh. Interesting. In that case, I think we go with Marty. I still want to do the same one. I think it's a really good buff. And we don't have anything that prevents an ambush, but honestly, I think we can tank an ambush at this stage. But we've been so lucky with these. We've got lucky with the Cove. We've got lucky with the Warrens, which we're in now. And I'm kind of feeling a bit cocky about going to the Wields, but I'm terrified of doing the Ruins. And I think a lot of the problem, well, at least part of the problem, is the people that we've been taking to the Ruins, apart from the fact they've not been ideal, just in general principles, they've been Ruins phobes. 12 food. For a task well done. Excuse me. Yeah, eat up. They've been afraid. They've taken extra stress damage in the Ruins, and the Prophet is a stress-dealing boss. No, I'm not halting. I mean, we didn't even make it to the Prophet. In most cases. But it seems like we've had the bad luck of either being in one situation or the other, where we can't hit the boss, but we can get through the rest of the ruins, or we can not get through the rest of the ruins, but we're well specced out for the boss itself. So you're marked for death, which is okay. I'm going to mark you for death. Oh, you haven't got any prop. That's really weird. Okay. Although you do have a benefit against protted, against marked things. DT's in the right place because uppercut isn't going to be valuable here anyway. I did forget to put guard on because you're an idiot. That's okay. So I think we mark here. I think it lasts for 3 rounds. Resist the debuff. It's only 40% resist, actually. Oh, what is the point in giving you all that dodge, huh? So we do... Can we stun it? No. That's fine. I think I'm just going to start with the Retribution game. Having this mark means that the boss will possibly attack us a lot. Only one round, though. So you're stunned, which is... Oh, you resisted. Thank you. Excellent. Very good. And now we do some damage versus marks. This is Beast. Somebody has damage versus Beast. End this one. Well, you're already being ended. What? Oh, it dodged. It has high dodge, but we can beat the shit out of it later. Is it DT? Is it... Ah, it's you. So you have damage versus Beast, which is great. Now, this is going to be not very useful. It's plus 27 dodge, actually. It's not going to stun the boss. There's almost literally... Holy shit. That's 120% stun resist, so we got extremely lucky to roll that. I was expecting it not to stun the boss, and I was okay with it not stunning the boss. Not stunning the boss. But what I really wanted to do was make sure that we had... Marty in that position, basically. Because now we can take advantage of the mark that we put on the boss, which is only going to last for one round. So... We're gonna lose it. Nice. Oh, no. Don't hit him. Oh, that's probably a problem. Do some damage. Throw the dagger. Great. Don't kill this thing first, for goodness sake. I hadn't even thought of that. Oh, goodness. Maybe we don't want to be using Retribution at all. Because if that thing... If he's gonna Retribute... Holy shit. If he's going to riposte against that thing, putting a mark on him, this thing's going to die fast. I don't want that to happen. Keep this mark up. So I'm going to let that wane and then do something else, basically. Now I wish I'd put guard up. Never mind. I feel confident that we can at least... is this everybody? It is. We could try and stun it. No, just hiss it. I feel confident that we will not die immediately. Well, we obviously won't die immediately because we will take Death's Door first. But I'm really hoping that Zeki survives this. 15. Yeah, we're fine. So don't put Retribution back on because if this thing dies first, this boss is going to get pissed the fuck off. So now we do this. 18 damage. We're doing great damage to this boss. And we're tanking the damage like champs as well, which is brilliant. And of course, the boss is going to hit what this thing tells the boss to hit. We don't want to set up Retribution. Yeah, we just keep crushing. The crit's good. That's really helpful. You know, we're doing 10% of its damage, basically, on every throw that we do. Or more. But I think at some point we'll be okay to set up Retribution, because even if this thing does... put it on there. We'll be okay. This has gone really well. And I'm actually quite happy to go and have a little wander around and see if we can win something else. How did you take more damage than you? Can we talk about this? Maybe it was just a bad roll against Zeki there, which I'm perfectly happy with. Yeah, one more of those. So this is nearly done. And these two. Right, so now we can set up our Retribution. Kind of hoping to get more out of that, so that this was not quite so close. Very close, but boss is nearly dead. The mark had come off, but we can do this. Now this guy goes stressed out, right?
No.
This guy don't mind. I don't, you can do that. Whatever. As long as Zeki gets a go. Zeki does not get a go. 2 damage, Death's Door. Literally 1 HP away from that. I think that's enough damage. you reckon?
Sure.
Take it. And then Zeke can just do this and hope for a good roll. 10.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you're really fast, which is the annoying thing here. And you are trying to stun all my people. Oh, okay. No problem. No worries. What did we win? Okay. Okay. Not the best.
Triumphant pride precipitates.
We'll continue. I'm a bit worried about our HP. Let's nom on some foods here. That's probably good enough. It can get us through the next combat. I really wish we could find a key. So maybe we will go looking for one. At any point, we can just leave. I'm happy to retreat from a combat and then, you know, exit the quest 100%. We should put Marty back in the right position. Oh, that was excellent. In fact, we should put everyone back in the right position. And next time, remember to put... Oh, that was the right position. My mistake. Remember to put Megistos at the front. It's really tempting to put the Bounty Hunter at the front. But I think if you're going to do that dance... If you're going to do that movement, you'd rather have the Bounty Hunter in the third position than the Man-at-Arms. So we'll lunge. Excusez-moi. We'll try and take out one of these, if possible. Not quite. Well, not even not quite, not quite. They're still one hit away, which is a sufficient amount of away. You are marked, which is fine, because you're going to mark yourself anyway. We will now try and finish this. As long as we don't miss on that one. Then we'll retribute on this one, which did dodge, but I think we still get retribution. We do. Riposte, of course. We will try and keep... What did I say about my throat? Maybe it's the direction I'm looking in. Maybe I sit back differently. Let's try this. I'm clutching at straws to try and figure out why my throat goes weird. Are you wearing... No. You've got this medal on you. I thought it was a representation of a trinket that you're wearing, but since you have two eye patches on, it's the same eye patch. Two eye patches on the same eye. Now we can actually do a lot of damage versus this, which is almost enough. But naturally, not actually enough. Let us crush you. Overkill by a considerable margin, but I don't feel too badly about it because it's dead and I'm not. So I'm happy with this. We seem to have made some perfect profit. Profit in terms of HP. Just going to throw daggers. I like throwing daggers. It turns out to be a lot stronger than I expected it to be. This did have some prot on it, so that was a good idea. I did it for the mark, but then I thought I'd check about the protection as well. Which means we can do that little bit more damage here. Not too concerned about the riposte at this stage. Because there's only one enemy. Riposte usually benefits when there are multiple enemies. Any of whom could hit you. Ow, okay. Marked. When there are multiple enemies and any of them could hit you, you'd stand a chance to get more damage out of it by doing riposte than you avoided by not doing something else. In this case, there's only one enemy, so we can only be hit once anyway. We might as well do just one hit. Why? What? Okay. Zeke, yes. Keep Marty alive, thank you. This is going really well, especially considering these... We don't have... No. Zeke is level 4, but only has level 3. Level 2 of these, we did upgrade the healing skills because Zeke is the healer. But, you know, it's not like we have leveled these people up to their level. So that went really well as well. And we don't have a key to open even this, which may have a key in it. It doesn't.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow.
I think we discard the torches, because if we run out of torches, we can leave. And now we just sort of hope for... I'm going to keep hoping for a key, and I'm going to keep hoping for some things that we can take home. We've done so well that at this stage, you know, not... Hello. Ooh. At this stage, we can just... Because we can leave at any time, which is the important part... Yeah, that was very likely to kill. then we should explore. We should just keep going. Mart and human. We have a human. It's not going to do that much damage to it. It does have high prop. So I think we'll do this. The debuff is going to be basically helpful to Magistos here, who can... How long does it last? 3 rounds. So maybe we move forwards now to avoid having to use a Shadow Fade. Did resist the stun, which is a bit of a shame. Now, you don't need healing, so I'm going to make sure you're topped up. It resisted the stun, which is a bit of a shame. It means it's going to get to possibly disease somebody. I think there's a disease attack in here. No, just a blight. Ow. Bleed. That's okay. It's 9 damage, which we can tank. And shell. Ooh, excuse me. See, there are 3 things that that one does for us. The mark synergizes with that attack and this attack. And it reduces the protection. So it increases our damage for 3 different reasons, which is excellent. We will crush you. Very good. What was I afraid of? I honestly don't know why the ruins have been such a problem for us. This is worth less than... This stack is worth less than that thing. So I guess we take it. So is this stack. But that stack is worth more or less. Stop talking. Open the sack. Money. Oh, I was going to say use a bandage and then get rid of those, but you don't need to, so... Eat up. If we get a hunger proc, we'll still have 4 food left after it. So we should not be afraid to use all the stuff that we came with to try and take home as much stuff as we can. Another surprise. This is going really well. Of course, they do... Oh, shit. I forgot to... Damn. They do, all attackers at once when they come out of it. So maybe flashing daggers here. That could be a good spread of damage, actually. 6 to 12 on this. 4 to 8 on this. Versus 17 and 11. So it's not that much different. And yet... We get to do it on 2. Oh! Do we have any bleeds? Maybe. Not. No. I think at this stage, what we actually try and do is focus on something other than the one with high protection. Because we can heal against it, but it'll take us a while to beat it. So what we want to really be doing, I think, is try to make sure the other things don't do us any damage at all if we can help it. Especially this one. Perfect. Because that one was... We've taken one out, so that thing is now going to do us 0 damage. So having 4 things doing us damage is probably worse than having 1 thing doing us damage, even if that one thing takes a lot longer to kill. That's my opinion. That's how I feel about it. Because if everything's... They all have such a diverse array of things that they can do to us as well. That the more we avoid giving them that opportunity, the better off we'll be. So I think at this point we just try and kill this. We can. We didn't. Now the thrown dagger here is probably going to be aimed at this, which has a lot of dodge. Couldn't you have... just one more... That's also a good dodge. And they get a go, which is a shame, because we'd like to kill that. And then, of course, you get a go where you do kill that. Or don't. Whatever. I'm not upset. Crit yourself, no worries. A bit selfish. Fine. The dodge is great. Everything survived that round somehow, which is a bit of a piss-off, to be honest with you. We could kill this in one hit. But I'm not sure I want to try. I think we just throw this. Make sure... make sure that doesn't do... In terms of overkill... Bagel is amazing at overkilling healing. And Martianus is amazing at overkilling damage. That was a 25 damage... On an enemy with 1 HP. As the light gains not as much overkill as Bagel doing 42 damage on someone who only had like 20 odd HP, but nevertheless, we just like hit this. I don't know whether it's worth doing any debuff to it. It's not. Look, watch. That was good. I mean, we could have wasted... We could have used a turn, which would turn out to have been wasted.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
But to do a debuff and a mark and stuff, but... Kind of glad we didn't. No keys still. Well, we'll keep going until we have basically thrown everything away and... Hello. More surprises. I'm as surprised as they are that they're surprised. Excuse me. Oh, that was the highest roll, actually. I'm okay with it. Let us set up... Let's do this. It puts this thing in this fumbling swipe mode. Stumbling scratch mode, which is perfectly good for me. And this is going to kill it.
Destroyed.
That was great. Do that again. Might as well... We could fail to kill it. We did. Okie dokie then. Excuse me. When this is a stumbling scratch, it will step backwards. Which is perfect. Rend for the old gods. It can do it from there, can it? Maybe stumbling scratch at the back. I understand. Yeah, try it. Yeah. That's what you get. Just kill this. I recognise that Marty could have killed that. Kinda don't give a shit. We might as well just get Marty to Shadow Fade at this point. Stun it again? Yeah. Now we get damage versus stunned as well. As long as it doesn't go first. It doesn't. Perfect. Well, slightly imperfect. We do have a bleed on us. Oh! Oh, oh, oh!
Foolish heart.
Who's stupid now?
Brought low and driven into the mud.
Let's get rid of the portrait and take the key. Then, go back one, which may stress people out. It didn't. Can we go back now? There we go. Too busy talking. We'll go to this room. This is ideal. This is going to give us so much money, which is going to be great because these people will level up. We've got many other people who have leveled up to level 6 of all things, which we haven't touched for ages, those people. And we have... other people at level 3 and 4 who need to be leveled up in order to take on, e.g., the ruins. So we get rid of this, we get rid of this, we get rid of this, we take all of those, and then we leave. Genuinely did not actually expect to get a key. But the amount of money that we have just come out of that with, 10, 12, 13, 14, 20, nearly 21,000 monies. Plenty of heirlooms. Not too many busts, I expect, but that's fine. You've come out with... Thick-blooded. Fine. Clotter has replaced Clutch Hitter. That's actually fine, because Zeke doesn't do that much actual damage. On purpose. That's my decision. It's not like... Not having to go at Zeke for being shit at damage. Zeke's not supposed to be doing damage. Nearly level 5 on those two. So these two can come out again. Actually, Martin, just, I believe, just did level up. And these two are not going to level up. So that... Those people can go out again. In fact, we should check. Hey, hey! Brothel is locked. Gambling hall costs... Changed by money. Okay. So you can't get into the brothel. Because it's laundry day. But everything else is cheaper. Is that now? Let's have a look. Brothel is locked. Right, let's see who we need to de-stress, because that's actually perfect timing. Oh, you won't, you fucking dick. Yeah, they look cheaper to me. Let's sort by level. So you've obviously leveled up, because you're supposed to be... You were down there. And Zeke was already level 4, so that's fine. just more level 4 now, I guess. Like, maybe we put... Why won't you drink? We'll only gamble. Well, now's as time as any. Now's as good time as any. So that's 1,050, which I believe is normal price. But we'll do it, because we've got some cash. Dutch. We should de-stress anyone we can, really. Because we're going to want them. We're going to want them out. Megistos has got some stress, but not a lot. And Sejiris is stressed all hell, but we haven't got anything for them to do, so... At this stage, I'm not too concerned about that. Let's have a look at the other boss, and then we'll decide what to do in the next episode. There is still a Warren's boss, which is the Unstable Flesh. Interesting. Like, we could upgrade this party again. Send them out. We could send them to the Weald to try and... No, we can't do that. Because we definitely need to be able to beat the crap out of the Fusilier so that the actual 12-pounder doesn't fire. And then there's the Ruin. So we're doing well here, I think. We're definitely doing well here. So this is going to be our next episode, I'm fairly sure. We'll just do that again. You know, everyone get in, get out, no one gets hurt. But before we do that, let's have a look to see if we can actually upgrade these people to an extent that I'm happy with. We'd use this a lot. We use this a lot. We use this a bit, but it wasn't really there to do damage. So I'm going to keep it as it is. This is a decent amount of protection on ourselves. So I'm actually going to level up. We didn't use it because I forgot, but it didn't matter. DT. We use that. We use that. Less 18% prop with a better chance of succeeding is pretty good. Shuffle single and stun it is okay. I don't want to spend money on completely unlocking one of these, but I'm wondering whether some of these are worth doing. That's a bleed. And this is a drag. Okay, and then up at level 4 now, Martinez has actually done something good with flashing daggers, so we will do this. And then Ziki. Honestly, I'm going to leave that like that. But we will also come to the blacksmith and try and get Marty a bit more leveled up here. And hopefully we get some decent amount of cash if we just do all that again. Spent it all. We should stop because we have literally spent all our money. Although, we got a new trinket that I honestly don't care for. Got another one of these. You know what? Let's sort by name. And then we can look for duplicates. Got two of these, which I never use. Got two of these, which I use a lot. Two of those, which may come in handy in the future. How much is it worth? 11. I think I'll sell that. We do tend to... They're common. Okay. That's pretty good. So we do keep those. What was the other one that we got? It was annoyingly common. Oh, we got that and we got this one. So I've sold them both. Yeah. Okay. Do we ever use this? I'm going to say no. Let's sell some stuff. Because then we can get some people leveled up and actually sort this out. Just get rid of the stuff you literally never use. Like, the ones you don't even consider, right? That's what we're trying to get rid of here. So stun resist. This. We might use some of these on low-level people. But honestly, the more we move away... The more of these we have for the specific characters, the more of these rares and uncommon ones that we have, the less these are any good. Like, these are the only really good ones in the common range. The rings and braces, the ones that do a decent amount of damage, especially against an individual type, which we're expecting a lot of that type. So, okay. That seems good. We can now afford to upgrade DT, so to hell with it, we'll do that in the next episode. We will probably do exactly what I just said. So I hope you will join me, and until then, thanks for watching.